Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. In today's Excel video, I'm going to use the unique function, the sort function. I'll combine sort with unique, and then I'm going to change numbers to text, and I'll explain why I would do that. Let's dive in right now. This question actually came to me, work question. Somebody said, Chris, I got a bunch of zip codes. I need to know what zip codes are unique. So you could do this with a pivot table, but just use the unique function equals UNIQ tab, pick up that range. That is the only required argument. The other ones are optional. You're done. There are your answers right here. Bold that. Right there, those are the unique values. Now, the question then became, no, Chris, that's great. I actually want to know the total number of unique. So I could come in here and do the count function and count these, but then I thought, what if that is what you want to know, the total number of unique, just mix it together. Equals count. Count will count numbers. And then I'm going to add unique and then just pick up this range. And I should, by the way, get four. We see there's four over there in column C, and I do. I thought about this for a second and I said, are those zip codes, are they numbers or text? Because zip codes should be text because you're not going to summarize or average zip codes. Also, I know it's some of the New England states, they have a leading zero. And if you notice, it doesn't pick up the leading zero when they're numbers. So I'm going to do this real quick. Let me just move this over. To convert numbers to text, I'm going to use the text function. Sorry about that. Equals text tab. I want to convert that first zip code to text. Two arguments for the text function. Both are required. The first one is what cell do you want to convert to text? The second one is what format? I know that the zip codes need to be five characters. One, two, three, four, five. That will put in the leading zero for any of those. There you go. I'm going to do a copy. Paste values. I don't need column C anymore. That triangle means they're text. The triangles don't print, but here you go. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect. It picked it up. Now, I had to do a single quote to keep that. So if you don't want to have to do the single quote, come up here to the Home tab, the number group. And you just tell these to be text to begin with. I believe now I should be able to get away without the single quote. And I did, it's still text, so no need for the single quote. And my unique function is still correct. Now that I converted them to text, I thought about this. I said, you know, I should have not used the count function. I should have used count A. The count function will only count numbers. Count and the letter A after it, count A, counts numbers and it counts text. So that's why this is zero here. So I'm just going to double click to get into edit mode. Add the letter A right there, count A. Look, it even tells you that. Counts the number of cells in a range that are not empty. So it's counting text and it's counting numbers. The answer is 5 right there. That is correct. So let's do it one more time, and now let's do it with departments. I got a list of employees. Here are their departments. I want to know how many unique departments. I actually want to see each one first, so I'm just redoing what I just did. So if you want to see them all, that is the unique function. Highlight your range. There you go. What if I want to see the departments and have them sorted in the correct order? That is the sort function added with the unique function. There is your formula right here. There is sort and unique. cool tip there for you. Also, now let's just do one more. I want to know the total number. So here we go one more time. Equals count A, unique, highlight this range. 7. Perfect. That's it. Ring the bell, subscribe. Any questions? I know I covered sort, unique, count, count A. Cool stuff in this video. Went from numbers to text. I appreciate your time. Have a great day.